to everyone for coming. My name is Joseph. My thesis is called Murakami World, Existential and Speculative Topics in the Work of Haruki Murakami. And my supervisor is Dr. Alexander Wolf. So just very quickly, who is Murakami? He's a Japanese writer, born in 1949. He's the author of numerous novels, short story collections, non-fiction pieces, and he's arguably the most widely read Japanese writer in Japan and internationally. He's also a translator. Murakami translates lots of American literature. He's very popular, like we said, and last year they opened the Murakami Library Institution in Tokyo at Masada. There's also been Oscar-winning adaptations of his work, so he's described by some scholars as phenomenal. So he's incredibly popular. Why philosophy and Murakami? So I have personal interest in the writer's work as a reader and a philosopher. I had an intuition or just a feeling that Murakami had some kind of philosophic existential depth, which I wanted to try to articulate or explore. Lots of the secondary literature on Murakami is written by Japanese scholars and focuses on Murakami, the individual, on Japanese society. So I wanted to do a more interdisciplinary approach. And I wanted to consider primarily Murakami's ideas and my interpretation of his ideas. So academic engagement with Murakami continues to proliferate. With Dr. Pyotra, we published a special issue on Murakami. And to my surprise, lots of the basically world-leading scholars on Murakami accepted writing an article for the special issue. So I think it shows that there is a lot of interest in Murakami. There's a lot of desire to publish on Murakami and extend the discussion on Murakami around the world. So in the reviews, one comment was, my aims and methodology could have been more systematic. So I tried to clarify my aims and methodology. So I wanted to explore and articulate philosophic themes in Murakami, Murakami's work. And I also reflected on philosophy of literature generally. And I do that through my own approach, which I called concept work. The methodology is interdisciplinary. I use a lot of continental philosophy, also analytical psychology, Jungian psychology, and comparative literature. We interpret and synthesize various philosophers and concepts, and the concept work is kind of hermeneutically both the content and the method of the thesis. In chapter two, we deepen an existing concept. We talk about self and psyche. And in chapter three, we try to generate a new concept. And just general comment, the focus of the thesis is on conceptual activity, rather than Murakami, the individual. So chapter one is called Concept Work, a Philosophic Approach to Literature. I established concept work as a philosophic approach. And we also consider what makes literature philosophic. I argue that both philosophy and literature work with concepts. And I also talk about concept work as a form of conceptual self-therapy, which I'll talk about at the end of the presentation. What do I mean by self-therapy? Murakami's work is understood to be philosophic literature, and it's also material for concept work or conceptual engagement, philosophic engagement. related to working with concepts in relation to the text? And how does it differ from, for example, reader response theory? Is that the concepts or the ideas from the text are not limited to that text, so you could take the ideas for your own conceptual projects. And also the idea that your response to the text is productive. Like my own thesis, it's a written response to Murakami. Also, I'm not trying to subordinate literary work to the philosophic. This is just one approach. Obviously, sociocultural interpretation is valid. I just wanted to focus on this kind of one-sided way to generate this this side of the discussion. So, in simple terms, concept work is imaginatively or creatively working with ideas, images, situations in literary material in order to extend the discussion, generate discussion, perhaps articulate original concepts, deepen engagement with Murakami, and also utilize material in your own creative work or project. Chapter 2, I talk about Haruki Murakami and Carl Gustav Jung. My master's was in Jungian psychoanalysis. Lots of the secondary literature on Murakami uses Jungian theory. Especially in the English language, the majority of it is inspired by Jungian theory. But they don't really talk about post-Jungian developments, so that's what I do in Chapter 2. We consider archetypal images, myth, the unconscious, the metaphysical or other world, metaphor, poesis. These are topics in Chapter 2. We do a close reading of a short story called Cream, and we look at an existential image. We're trying to demonstrate that Murakami's fiction does actually provide material for conceptual engagement. And we look at the concept of self and psyche in more detail. And in conclusion from that chapter, we mentioned that Murakami and Jung, they both have like a metaphorical perspective on the world. And importantly, the metaphors are existentially situated. So lots of the secondary literature on Murakami is quite subjective. So it's reflects back on Murakami, the writer, or for example, the Murakami character. Everything's related to him. It's quite, so that's what we mean by subjective. We're trying to consider the character's relation to the world and to other characters. So I think in Murakami there is a struggle with the characters trying to escape this kind of inner mind and to relate. And in Murakami's most recent novel, perhaps the characters are beginning to relate to the world. The main character has a daughter in the most recent novel. Okay, so chapter 3, existential metaphors and conceptual persona. We look at existential images in the works of Heidegger, Camus, Sartre, Levinas. We talk about how in existentialism there may be difficult to express certain points, certain fundamental points of existentialism. So that's why existentialists often employ images. So the image is the intersecting point between philosophy and literature. We talk about conceptual persona, hyper-authorship. We elaborate a new concept, which I call fuzzy authorship. Chapter 3 is talking about this character here. He is called the sheep man. He's a recurring character in Murakami's novels. And we say that he articulates a notion of imaginative connection related to self and identity. And importantly, his function in the novel and the words that he says and his actions are reflective of the thought that he personifies. So he is somewhat of an embodied or personified thought. And we argue that perhaps he is actually an author of equal status to a reader response or the biological writer. So the main point is that characters in a novel are not directly, may not be directly representative of the writer. So the sheep man, for example, what he talks about in the novel, he is somewhat independent, and he's not only an intrapsychic phenomenon of Murakami or the Murakami characters. So we talk about authorship, or in general, philosophic writing is fuzzy, and by fuzzy we mean indeterminate, reworkable, it's open to repossession by anyone involved with that work. So, in conclusion, throughout the novel, throughout the project, we talk about things like abnormal discourse, we talk about self-definition or self-edification from Gadamer. So, philosophy of literature is not approached as knowledge. It's not a way of knowing, it's more like a way of perceiving, a way of relating. And Richard Rorty, he says, it's a way of coping. So this self-therapy that I talked about, it relates to self-expression. So trying to find new, interesting ways of expressing ourselves. So readers who enjoy Murakami, they usually enjoy him because they relate to the novel. The novel has some kind of emotional importance for the reader. So the readers can, through philosophic engagement, try to make better sense of themselves, of the work, of their relation to experience. I won't go too much into it, but at the end of the project we talk about philosophy as speculation, and we refer to Varine, and who calls speculative projects are a form of self-writing, which also Foucault talks about self-writing, what is an author. And one of the reviewers mentioned that I should read more Foucault, so I did. And there's an interesting quote where he says, fiction should not be limited by the figure of the author. What are the modes of existence of this discourse, and how can we appropriate the discourse for ourselves? So I think that's connected to the speculative project. And importantly, basically, I think that this thesis is a speculative project. So although we're talking about Murakami, it leads onto talking about philosophy of literature, talking about philosophy itself, and importantly, I think philosophy incorporates this kind of imaginative, creative process. And we also talk about the different, lots of the writers in the project, they divide different areas of thought. So for example, reason and imagination, the poetic and the speculative. But we wanted to consider fiction and reality, literature and philosophy, more along a continuum or shared space. And so work with philosophy and literature is equally productive, equally meaningful. And I think a key part of Murakami is this kind of attempt to articulate one's often strange experience of reality. And so self-therapy also connects to this idea of self-knowledge in the philosophic tradition. So just to overview, working with Murakami, we talked about existential themes. We also composed a speculative project. The concepts that we work with in Murakami, they could be repossessed or utilized, transposed to other projects. They're not limited to just talking about this one story. And with the shared space between philosophy and literature, which Murakami occupies, is this potential working through concepts imaginatively. And so existential and speculative topics can be established in philosophy or in the literary texts. So key contributions. My writing style is not very systematic, so I try to tell you what I think the key contributions are. So I think we have a new perspective on Murakami, talking primarily about concepts, philosophic topics, separate from the biographical or sociocultural context of Murakami. And we're trying to move past this kind of subjective approach, which is found in the literature. We talked about two existential images, and we worked with the images conceptually, and we utilized it in the thesis. We're trying to bring a contemporary writer into the philosophic discourse. Specifically, how does Murakami relate to existential works? And we've also tried to apply philosophy to a current and challenging topic. So just to quickly respond to some of the comments from